A doctor in Nova Scotia says he's fed up with writing sick notes. He doesn't just object to the demands on his time. He says some companies ask for notes that are so detailed they're violating the privacy of his patients. Carolyn Ray has the story.
Every Monday, Dr. Paul Young knows what's facing him at work. Not just a waiting room full of patients, but requests for sick notes.
I suspect if employers had to pay for the sick notes, they'd be less likely to demand a sick note after a one-day illness.
In just 5 years of practice, he's noticed a dramatic change. He's no longer scribbling sick on a doctor's prescription pad. He's now filling out several pages of paperwork for each request. And sometimes he's being asked to include copies of a patient's chart.
I give the as little information as possible. The employers should not need to know a medical diagnosis. They should all they need to know is that there's a medical reason for it.
The notes are for people who miss 2 days of work or more for everyday illnesses. Gastrobugs, migraines, a common cold. When a woman took 2 days off after having a miscarriage, he says he was asked to detail the condition that caused her to miss work.
I don't think I'm the first person to write a letter back to an insurance company saying that it's inappropriate.
While insurance companies are bad, the worst offender, he says, is Morneau Chapelle, which provides absence management services to businesses.
Morneau Chapelle says it's sensitive to the time demands on doctors and is only asking for the information that's required. It also says it is trying to protect an employee's privacy, so it only sends the relevant information on to an employer.
That's not good enough for the doctor, who wants to get back to focusing on his practice. He's calling on the province to create a law that would ban sick notes for any illness that has someone off less than 5 days. Carolyn Ray, CBC News, Bedford.
All right, last November, Ipsos conducted a poll for the Canadian Medical Association. It found a majority of working Canadians oppose allowing employers to require sick notes for minor illnesses. 82% of Canadians said they would be likely to go into work ill rather than get a sick note. 54% said if their work required a sick note for a cold or minor illness, they would go to their family doctor, while 6% said they would not be able to get a sick note. So, should employers be allowed to demand sick notes from their workers? What are the implications for patient privacy and the quality of health care? And should there be legislation into the labor law for a minimum of sick days? Joining us from Toronto to address these questions, Brittany Andrew Amofa. She's the Policy and Research Manager at the Broadbent Institute. Tasha Carradine, she is the founder and CEO of Ellipsum Communications. And Anthony Lacavera, he is the founder and CEO of Global Live. All right, Anthony, let me ask you, first of all, what do you think? Doctor's notes for 2 days or more, is that fair?
Carol, I mean, I'm wondering if we're in high school or in elementary school here when I look at these laws. I mean, in all of my years of building teams, building companies, and focusing on building great company cultures, I always found this rules around this to be just facially absurd. And I've always avoided it. I've never required it. And the truth is that over the years, you can quickly identify people that are just abusing the system and just taking days off for no reason. And those that are really legitimately ill, there's no need to call them on it and put them through the grief of going to a doctor's office and already being sick, and then of course all the knock-on effects of people coming to work then sick and actually making others sick and hurting the productivity of teams, everyone at work getting upset, or going into a doctor's office and sitting there when they really should be in bed. So I think the whole thing is ridiculous, and the sooner we can put it to rest, the better.
Tasha?
Well, Anthony, I don't think you've ever worked in the public sector, and I say that simply because in Ontario here, when the policy for sick days for teachers changed, for example, from a blanket policy, you could accumulate them, to a use it or lose it policy, all of a sudden sick days went up that were used by 30%. There are situations, I think, where employers have a right to demand sick notes because there may be abuse in the system. And that is a problem that I think is a case-by-case situation. I agree that, generally speaking, most employers will cut employees slack, but if sick days seem to happen an awful lot without necessarily great explanation, or you have a particular employee that you can't, especially in the public sector, simply say, well, that person, you know, takes too many sick days, I'm going to get rid of them. You can't do that. There have to be other ways to make cases and show that the person is actually abusing the system. So it's unfortunate, but I think that there has to be a balance struck between the employee's right to be sick, obviously, and have some privacy, and the employer's right to know whether that is actually genuine.
All right, Brittany, your take.
Yeah, I just want to touch on what Tasha just said for a moment, she mentioned that sick days increased by 30% in the public sector. I don't think we can reasonably infer that that spike in the amount of sick days that were taken were false. Maybe people, because they had the sick days, felt like they should use them and they felt comfortable enough to use them. I feel like it's very hard to decipher between that data what's causing that. So I do want to caution that a little bit. But I think from an operation standpoint, when we're looking or assessing our healthcare system, any reason to send somebody to get a sick note causes delays. It forces people to wait in wait rooms for who knows for how long in walk-ins or at their family doctors. We already know Nova Scotia specifically has a shortage of doctors in that province. We're causing needless delays within our healthcare system, a system that is already at capacity. So if we're looking at purely from an operational standpoint and to ensure that we're having a healthcare system that is functioning, that is efficient, and that can actually serve those who are in need of care, sick days do not do it any justice. So I think we need to look at it more carefully to be like, how is it, who is this helping specifically, and what are the long-term ramifications of forcing people to get sick notes when we already know that it's not doing any justice on our healthcare system?
Just sort of echo the operational reference that Brittany made. I mean, in my experience, it's very easy to identify people that are abusing the system versus those that are legitimately ill.
How do you do that?
You can see patterns in their behavior, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, I think you really just quickly see patterns in frequency of people's truancy from work, and it becomes obvious. Those that miss and are legitimately sick are also the ones that most often come back and work doubly hard to make up for lost time. It's just readily apparent in many different ways. So I really don't think, I certainly agree with Tasha that if there's a need for controls, but I think that employers have the ability very easily to implement those controls just by watching the behavior of the teams. And by the way, and other team members will react positively or negatively to team members that are ill because they know actually what's going on. So you can really suss it out that way too. It's not hard to figure out.
That is true. I think though that it's the question here of laws like the one in Ontario, for example, they allow employers to get sick notes, but they don't mandate them to do so. And so I think there's a discretionary element here that employers obviously don't want to antagonize their workforce either. What was said though about Morneau-Chapelle was interesting because that's a situation where the company's sort of outsourcing its sick note policy in a way to a third party,
right,
and maybe aren't even fully aware of the impact this is having. So I think, like I said, there has to be a balance struck, but I think that there should be still a right to get a sick note if an employer feels it's warranted in a situation.
What about the idea of getting the government to step in? I mean, I know some jurisdictions across the country are looking at mandatory sick days written into the provincial labour legislation. Dr. Paul Young from Bedford, Nova Scotia, we just heard from, wants to see sick notes banned for under 5 days. Would that work? And then when you hit the 5-day limit, then you have to go get your sick note.
I think it's an excellent idea. I think we saw most recently here in Ontario in Bill 148 that was introduced by the Liberal government, which has now been largely reversed with Bill 47 by this new government.
We still have the 10 days, though, in the provincial legislation, do we not?
It's 10 days. I think 8 of it is...
unpaid.
Yes, unpaid. Thank you for filling that in. But there was some language in there that mentioned that sick notes weren't required for illnesses. Mm-hmm. So I think that's an excellent a policy or legal change that should be encouraged. And I go back to my original point. We are hoping, what I imagine as Canadians who highly regard our free healthcare system, looking to ensure that it remains efficient, looking to ensure that people can get the care that they need when they need it. And by forcing people to, or maybe calling on those when needed, if an employer is using discretion to get a sick note, it's just causing needless delays. And there is no evidence to say that a sick note, making sure that people get a sick note, discourages people from taking sick days. There's no evidence there. So again, it's just an extra hurdle by an employer who can exercise their power over an employee for no reason at all.
I think you have to distinguish though between situations, and I understand what Brittany is saying in terms of proof, like what proof do we have? But if you have a situation, and I go back to the teachers that were given a change in policy from you have sick days that you can bank to a use it or lose it within the year policy, all of a sudden the number of sick days taken, especially towards the end of the school year. And this has been documented for 5 years now since this happened. All of a sudden, they take more sick days than they used to take. There is no evidence that teachers are suddenly all falling sick at that time, but they are taking the days because they are allowed to take them, and so they call in sick. And in a situation like that, I feel it's not fair, because this is not a policy saying that you simply have sick days and therefore can take them. It's if you are sick, you have a sick day. So I think you have to distinguish in situations like that, where maybe in those cases, yeah, a note would be warranted at a certain point, because otherwise people will take advantage of the system.
I mean, I agree with Tasha on that point for sure. And I think that what ends up happening is if you allow abuse to go on, then of course it's going to proliferate. And this is mm-hmm. why I really am opposed to having sick days written into labor laws. I think that this is something like we're adults here, and we need to treat our teams as adults and team members. And I think I've been successful at building great corporate cultures by just giving everybody that obvious space that an adult
but that's
deserves.
You, Anthony. That's you.
And so, well, but I'm not saying I haven't identified people that abuse it. I'm
yeah.
saying, and I have disciplined people, and I have terminated people that have abused it, but you can easily identify those people if you just let some time go by.
And it sounds like you're a great employer, and I think it's a great example that you're setting here by using that sort of discretion and having that sort of company culture. However, I think we have labor laws for a number of different reasons. We have labor laws to not hire children, etc. We have labor laws to ensure that there's no gender discrimination in the workplace, etc. So it's just, we have a number of laws put in place because as human beings or as adults, we can always count on each other to ensure we're making mature adult decisions. And those are the reasons why we do have laws.
Of course, but
teachers
those are very
also
different
just
examples
one
than,
profession.
You know, than a sick note for
teachers
an adult.
Yeah. Teachers are also just one profession, and I think it's fair to say that one profession shouldn't ruin it for all. I think if we're going to look at this very specific example with teachers, then that profession should be reckoned with and analyzed, and maybe some suggestions should be offered to help that particular field. But I don't think it's fair for all workers across the board to be painted with the same brush, because teachers, there's this one specific spike in data in regards to teachers.
There was one case, though, that I was reading as well of a company, and I can't remember what the actual product they made. It was a manufacturing company, and they said that because the two-day sick policy that you referenced earlier, Brittany, the fact they have, we have 10 days now in the law, two of which are paid, eight of which are not, the company said when that came in, all of a sudden, by February, 80% of their workforce had taken the 2 days, whereas in previous years they had not. It cost the company a lot of money. It frustrated the company, too, because there's that sense that people may just be taking those days because they can, and that affects the morale also in the company itself. So
Absolutely.
Again, it's like a dance you have to do between the employer's right to know and the employee's right, obviously, to take time when they need to.
Absolutely. And then the folks that don't take advantage of that are sitting there saying, why am I at work when I could have taken 5 days off? I mean, you've got to avoid that happening, too.
Yeah. Okay. We'll leave it on that note. Brittany Andrew Amofa, Tasha Carradine, Anthony Lacavera, thank you for your insights this evening.
Thank you.
Thank you, Carol.